the DEXIS iOS How to Correct a Mislabeled Arch Tips and Tricks recorded class. This recorded class is designed for clinical team members. It provides some tips and tricks that you can use to acquire a more efficient 3D model. By the end of this help demo, you should be able to correct a mislabeled arch. In this tutorial, we will explore how to correct a mislabeled arch. To achieve this, we need to change the orientation of the arch. At the beginning of the scan, I intentionally scanned the arches so they would be incorrectly labeled. As a result, and as you can see, the scan is upside down. Let's now explore how we can correct this. If the arch is mislabeled, you don't need to stop during the scan to correct this. You can come back and fix it later. As you can see, there is a button here that you can select in order to switch the upper and lower arch. Now you will notice, as I point to different areas, that a little tooltip pops up. That will let me know what's going to happen when I click that button before I do so. Once I choose the switch button, the arch is now properly labeled with just one click. My mandible and maxilla are now correctly oriented, they are just reversed from what I had before. I will now evaluate the scan, look at it from various angles, and see what I have captured. I make sure I have all the data I need. You will also notice that I captured some things like the lip, or the tongue, or maybe someone's finger. You don't have to worry about that. When we proceed to the refining process, the software will go through them and cut all of these out for me. In this way, you don't need to worry about moving or cutting those different pieces of the scan out, unless it's something severe. I can also look at an individual arch at a time. I can change between the upper arch and the lower arch, and when I hover over these buttons, it tells me what's going to happen if I select them. I will now look at the upper arch and then switch back to the lower arch to evaluate them. I can see that everything here looks good. I have got all the data that I possibly need to make any appliance or restoration based on what I have captured. Once I have validated that I have all the information I need, I can simply move on. If there was a big hole and there was a void someplace where I needed to have some better data, I could simply go back and continue scanning, as we have done here. I could just pick up the scanner now and start scanning. But if everything looks good, I'm going to move on to the next step and it will now start the processing. This concludes the DEXIS iOS How to Correct a Mislabeled Arch Tips and Tricks recorded class.